Hello and welcome to Q&A Friday. I am Raghav and you are watching the channel Automation Step by Step. And today we are going to take up a question asked by Justin from Sri Lanka, and he says, I'm Justin Lambert from Sri Lanka. I like your series of tutorials. In my case, I'm manual tester. I need to convert to automation. How can I do that? Can you give me the path? Justin, thank you for asking this question. This is a very general query that I get from a lot of viewers from my channel, that I'm into manual testing and I want to switch to automation testing. What are the options for me? So there are basic five things that you need to do. The first one is you have to select a automation tool or library that is very common and widely used and is easy to learn. And one of the options that you can go with is Selenium. Selenium is open source, it is very widely used and it is easy to learn. So this is something that you can start with, and you will find a lots and lots of freely available online resources and tutorials on this. So this is something you can start with. Of course, if you are in an organization and they are already using some particular tool or library into automation testing there, then that will be the best option for you to learn, so that you can start and switch into automation testing in your own organization. But if that is not the case, then of course Selenium should be the best thing to start with. So that was number one. Number two is you have to implement some sample projects, some sample automation projects on your own. And this is very, very important, because unless you do some hands-on and you have some practical hands-on experience, you will not be able to move into automation testing. So you have to set up something from scratch. Whether you are learning Selenium, so you have to set up a Selenium framework for testing web applications, and you have to do a lot of hands-on. So this is very important. Number three is, after you have learned these basic skills, if you have the option to move into automation testing in your own organization, that will be very good, because then you will get an experience of real world projects, how exactly automation testing is done for real projects, and in the environment of all that, you know, setup. That will be very useful, and a very useful experience for you going forward to go to the next level. Just in case if you are not able to do that, then the fourth thing is you have to start looking for jobs according to your profile and skill set outside. In my last video, I covered this topic of how to find for automation testing jobs. I will provide the link of that video in the description below, so you can watch that. And the fifth thing is you have to keep learning every day, and there is no alternative for knowledge. So you have to make sure that you keep increasing your skill set, you keep learning new tools, new techniques, new concepts of automation. So make sure you keep increasing your knowledge base on automation. That will help a lot in switching to automation testing. So that was all for this session. In case you have any other queries, you can email me at ask.qnafriday@gmail.com. Please mention your name and location along with your questions. I will meet you in the next session of Q&A Friday. Thank you for watching.